Oh gosh, this is wonderful. We are wonderful.
You think so?
Our first night out as Governor and First Lady Mitchell. What a rush. And now Glamour magazine wants to put me on the cover as the most dazzling First Lady of a state. I even beat out that annoying Sandra Lee and her semi-homemade husband.
Well, I still can't believe it. How did I get here?
Hard work. Luck. Besides, everything you have been fighting for finally resonated with the voters.
Yeah, all that got me was an 18-year stint in the state senate.
Oh, which is really getting old.
Did you get all the groceries I wrote down?
Yes, Ma.
My good boy. You've been the man of this house for so long, I don't know what I'll do when you go away.
It's time, Ma.
I know. I've accepted the fact that you're going to be a soldier.
I don't mean that. It's time I get to know my father.
My honey, please don't ruin your birthday with this talk.
I can't keep going on like this, Ma. A part of me is missing. I've already reached out to him.
Don't do it.
There were so many times where you would point to the screen and say, see, that's your father.
You'll get hurt.
I'm a man going off to war and you're worried about me getting hurt by him?
You are from a close chapter in his life. He is not the type of man who looks back.
If it hadn't been for you, I wouldn't have made it this far. You really pushed me to run for governor. Screw your courage to the sticking place. You kept telling me it will not fail.
I did say that, didn't I?
Yes, you did. Spoken like a true Lady Macbeth.
You wanted a wife as ambitious as you. You got one.
You never told me how you two got together.
I was 19 years old. And ours was a conservative family in a poor neighborhood that the yuppies were starting to move back into. And I studied hard. I was known around the block as the girl who thought she was too good for anyone. And then I met a man from legal aid who was helping us block a move by real estate developers who were trying to take over our building and push us out. He was full of high ideals. He was very smart. And after a year of working with us, he helped us to win.
Was that my father?
Yes. And over that year, I fell in love with him. The last night of summer, all the tenants turned a back lot into a victory party to celebrate the fact that our building had become a co-op. The place was full of music by Fefita La Grande and the most delicious food this side of Santo Domingo. And I wore my best dress and a pretty flower in my hair. And I danced all night with the man who I saw as my hero. That was a very special night for us.
Go on, Ma.
And then he left in pursuit of his political dreams. And I found myself alone and pregnant, my worst fears realized. And when I told him about it, the man with the high ideals only offered me money to terminate. I couldn't do it. Mm-mm. The night that you were born, he was announcing his run for the state senate.
Sometimes, I feel like I'm walking in shoes that are just a little bit too big for my feet.
Then grow a pair of bigger feet.
What shocks me most is how in stride you're taking all this.
That's because I was born for this. I always knew I'd be the wife of a powerful man.
And you knew I'd be that man.
I knew you'd take some work, but I've always believed in you.
I just wish I could be enjoying all this more right now.
He came to the hospital, and he held you. I wanted to name you Jaime. But he insisted on James. And then he drew up a legal agreement in order to keep me quiet in exchange for a generous monthly sum.
What did he do?
I signed it. I held my peace. I raised you myself. Made sure you went to Catholic school, the Boy Scouts, summer camp. I think I did well by you.
You did, Ma.
So now you're here and you say he wants to see you. I just don't buy it. What could you possibly gain from this?
Brown scruffy shoes.